Ah, so bright I can't see. Ah, good, good ghost.
Holy crap, dude, there's a ghost in front of you. Further in front of me so I can see what I'm doing. Take
doms, taking it, take it, take it, dumb on, take it, take it.
The dead center of Mario Mario running towards me, my god. That's so craxy, I can't even know my breath. I thought I heard the sound. Man, you are so fast with those abilities. It's like, you know? It's like, just speed!
Speed! Speed! Speed!
So good. What was that food item in the original? Because it wasn't pizza. I'm sure it wasn't pizza. Don't talk suddenly like you're talking to an audience. You sound so stupid. I figure anything is likely to be new or exciting. It's gonna happen. Well, there was one new thing that happened. The, sudden advent of, Heavy Lobster music playing in the last Crusher room in, stage 6-5. Egg Engines. You know, Egg Engines 5, how it has those three rooms where it goes. Well, the Crushers come down. Well, in the last room, it suddenly started playing Heavy Lobster's theme instead of that. Suddenly started playing that music instead, which pointed out to me by Gio. I was talking to Gio about it, because she's like the only person I talk to regularly who's also played the game. She thinks that it might be because Scope Shot didn't make it into this remake, so they used the music that was. Because I didn't realize until she said that. Oh yeah, that's right. Heavy Lobster's theme was in Return to Dreamland. It was part of the Scope Shot minigame. It played at the very, very end when you beat the DDD robot, but then it came back. Like, it was like all scary. Because you know, you make it to the end of the DDD round in a. You made it to the end of the DDD round in Scope Shot, and suddenly. But then, like, after destroying the entire outer shell of the robot, it's like endoskeleton, like, comes to life, and it's all freaky, and it, like, attacks you, and it starts playing Heavy Lobster music because it's just so shocking. And it was actually, like, kind of, like, legitimately scary, because it's, like, it's like a zombie, and it's playing this, like, appropriately panicked, scary music. It's a scary Zora amount. If I could stop saying the word scary, maybe I would be able to get something done with that. Commentary-wise, and, like, say something. I don't even know if I'm gonna post this. I'm thinking of recording an LP of, the Magolor Epilogue, just recording an LP of the Magolor Epilogue before I do anything else, because I'd like to LP, oh, this, bombs? It's yours, my friend. I'd like to do an LP of, like, what I wanted to do was do an LP of the extra one. That was what I was gonna do. And I think I'll still do that, but, you know, obviously I want to. Owie. Thank God you guys don't have any stupid arena bullshit.
No, three brothers!
There we go. Gee, that was easy. Man, that's the easiest time I've ever had with this level. I remember this level used to be a huge pain in the ass, but once you've done it a couple times, like that big key run, I mean, really, this level deserves to be kind of feared in terms of how hard it is to 100%, because this is like one of the only levels. Well, this game has a key run that takes place in the room after you get the key, so you can't die to reset the key run. If you mess up the key run, you have to start the whole level over, because you get the key in the room before you have to start. You have to carry it through, like, a whole bunch of hazards. So if you lose, there's no way to go back to where you get it. If you fuck it up, there's no way to go back to where you got the key. We're always enemies here. Oh, you know what? Forget to come up here. playing this music, huh? Peculiar. So accustomed to, you know, them taking any excuse they can to start playing some, you know... I'm really surprised they aren't playing, like, Green Greens in this room or something. I guess this was before they started doing that. They started constantly jerking themselves off with nostalgia, which I don't even mind in this game, in this series' case so much. I think the series... I don't know. I think the fact that basically all the music in this series is done by one person, or not one person, but like the same very small group of composers, like Juni Ishikawa and Hirokazu Ando are responsible for like 85% of the music in the Kirby series. So, you know, I am absolutely okay with, you know, it doesn't bother me when they want to like, plus like all the music is great. I don't know, I'm trying to think of an example of a series where I don't... I guess the Mario series would be the biggest one. Well, mostly because the Mario series is so shallow. Like, if Mario games pulled from half as many games as Kirby games tend to pull from, like, when they do stuff like that... But when Mario games do it, it's basically all just Mario 1 or, like, Donkey Kong. It's, like, all the oldest possible stuff. Because everybody working on the games is, like, old-ass geriatrics trying to relive their glory days. Their gory days. Of course, well, you can say the same thing about Hirokazu Ando and Juni Ishikawa. They've been around since the very beginning. I forgot I was gonna have to do this. I've gotten a platinum on every single one of these, so... Stop hiccuping! I know I just ate, and I shouldn't be recording right after I eat, but... Jeez, man.
I'm telling you!
Dump 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 Whew. Scary. And how cool would it be if I could, like, totally nail this? Whew, that was close. I was taking a big risk there. He came from 10 years of future killing, so he can't relax yet. Animals are all becoming violent due to Gygax's influence over the evil in their minds. It is the truth, so listen. It's like, what are you telling me it is the truth for? Like, I'm already listening to you. You don't need to tell me to listen. I'm literally already listening to you, you old fogey. How old Buzz Buzz is, actually. But that always struck me as odd. He's like, oh, it is the truth, so listen. It's like, what are you talking about? Okay. Stupid. Okay, now. Wait, shit, I need to hit that again. Whew, that was close. I'm probably not gonna make the platinum here because, I mean, the time it took for me to figure out what the hell was going on there is... I spent way too long in there. That was like a good 30 seconds I spent in that one room, and that's not tenable. Thankfully, most of the stuff in this challenge is absolutely, like, nothing. Most of what you're doing in this challenge is absolutely nothing. Just, like, holding right and pushing the jump button. Most of this challenge is super, super easy. There's only, like, a couple parts of it that are really bad. And it's not even, like... It's not even, like, bad in, like, a way where it's, like... I don't know how to describe it, but it's, like... This is definitely the easiest one to get a platinum on, I think. Yeah, that's right. Jeez. I'm so stupid. I don't remember how to do anything in this game. Those new challenges, I was pretty impressed at how much they felt like the old challenges. Like, I wondered if the same... Oh, you dumb fuck. I didn't think I'd be able to make it up there. Well, if I hadn't already lost the platinum before, I definitely have now. Man, this is... I barely remember this. Well, I do remember it, but it's like... I remember it... what's actually weird is that I remember it way more clearly than I feel like I should. Like, I feel like I remember... Wait, you need that. You need that to get the bomb. Yeah. This last bitch. Shit. Dude, get up there! I'm gonna have to do this again. Ain't no way. Okay, so don't drop down off that ledge, because you'll land there and you'll have to do a slide or whatever, so just walk off the left side. Jesus. What is the threshold for that? Because I definitely didn't... I didn't get no damage. Item challenge. Hobby. Wickerby. Platinum is 44200. Wow. That's for real. Yeah, no problem. Now that I remember, hopefully I remember what the fuck I'm doing here. If I could shut up, that would probably help too. Because I think a large part, you know, I'm playing too casually because I'm talking. If I wasn't talking, I'd be tryharding a lot more. I'd be getting a lot more frustrated, probably. So that's no good. You don't want to get all angry. There we go. Just walk forward with this. Don't try to sprint. Regret it. That was good. I wonder how many times people have actually died there. I wonder if I've ever died there. Because I just, like, totally missed the bomb box. I wouldn't be surprised if I had a couple times. I wonder if it would actually just straight up kill you. I bet it would. Boy, that's... How the hell did I get that 7-10 split? Or, that's not what... Just bonk that. There we go. Oh, that's good, because when he actually does that... Okay, don't forget to kill those guys. Glad I remembered to do that, because that would have been bad. Yeah, see, I'm pretty sure I'm, like, 30 seconds ahead of where I was before. Because didn't I get out of there with, like, 0-0 on the clock? I don't think it was 2 minutes flat remaining, either. Maybe it was. Careful. Get out of the way, dude. Come on, Scooby, pick up the pace. Okay, so what we're gonna do here is we're going to grab you. Grab you, I said! Come in here. Grab this, throw it right there. Grab you. Pick it up. There. Now, are you gonna put me right in front of the door? No, you're not. Okay. I can't remember. I can never remember exactly. Now, don't walk. Now, don't jump there, because then you'll regret it. Man, quit frame ruling my ass. Dang, baba ass, bus stop, bitch ass. What the shit? What the fuck? What the shit? Ugh, hit the shit. Okay, so this should be... And all I gotta do is not muck this up, and we should have it here. Go zero, go zero, go zero, go zero, go zero, go zero. Shit. You fucking cocksucker. We still got it. I'm sure. Even for a Nelwyn. I'm sure. Even for a Nelwyn. We had over... We had like 40 seconds left there. 39, yeah. Are you kidding me? How much am I missing? I am less than 150 points off. You gotta be kidding me. Oh my god. Okay. Okay. One more time. this time. This time, absolutely no hesitation. There we go. Perfect. I wonder if it'd be possible to, like, jump down there. I don't think so, but that should be pretty badass if it was. Man, I wonder what the extra mode adds. I think the extra mode adds coins between those. Okay, so in here we have this thing. So just dash to the side. That's fine, actually. Wait. Once more. Come on. Oh, that was lucky. I just so happened to jump as I ran into that guy, and he didn't deal any damage to me. Okay, so now this part's easy. This part's effortless. It's so cold. I'm so cold, baby, I'm so cold. Don't move into position happily. There we go. Shit, get out of the fucking way, you stupid pricks! Oh my god, are you kidding me? What the fuck was I supposed to do there? Like, how the hell am I supposed to go any faster when everything is on cycles? If you get there, if you don't get, like, and that's not even something that, where, like, if you get there 255 frames in advance, that's, like, something that happened that depends on, like, how long ago the room loaded. Like, there's not that much going on in that room. You really can't do that part much faster. Pretend it matters. Dump, take a dump, take a dump on the can. Dump on the toilet. Yeah, I guess that would be something else you could emphasize, is not lingering on these platforms for too long. You know, the moment you can make the jump, go for it, because there's no reason not to. Slop. Yup. Get it? Yes, I did. I couldn't tell! Ugh. Am I ahead? I literally can't tell if I'm ahead. I'm pretty sure I'm, like, exactly on pace with where I was on that first attempt, that just barely didn't make it to platinum. You really can't go that much faster here. Like, right here, you can't go any faster because if you... Why the hell did you stop going to the right? Did I hit? I feel like I tripped. I literally feel like I just tripped over the geometry somehow. It's not, like, suddenly I just stopped. Dude, get in the fucking boot. Neck. Bastard. Fucking crack. It's a good thing you don't actually have to land directly on top of these things. Like, you can go into them at like a diagonal, and it still works. Yeah, the fact that you actually have to kill every single enemy really puts, like, kind of a damper on your ability to actually do this any faster. There we go. That was good. You can't do this part any faster, not until you get to the very end of it, because just as soon as you grab that coin, just immediately hop off. Because there's nothing in your way of making that jump. You know, here, you have to wait a little bit because you have the spikes here. You can't make that jump with cleanly. Right here, I don't think it's possible I don't think it's possible to hit that bomb block fast enough that that guy doesn't bump into the wall again. I wonder if inhaling this guy and then inhaling the key would be faster, but I'm not confident that it would be, so I'm not gonna go for it. Thankfully, you can just hold up there and it doesn't hurt you, and hurt you none. How the hell did 4 seconds pass in the last, well, 4 seconds, but like 3 of those were in a loading screen. I thought time didn't pass during the loading screens. On the loading screen. Because, you know, the loading screen isn't... Get out of the fucking way! What? When they get to the edge, when they get to the outside of that chute, they turn around instantly, but when they get to the inside, they linger there for like a full second. It's like, how the hell am I supposed to shave off 5 seconds when the enemies literally get in the way and then don't move? You know, the worst part is that I don't even know how much time I need to shave off. You know, for all I know, I have to shave off like a quarter of a second. I mean, the amount of... Like, I don't know how much points you get for, like, any given amount of time. I have no idea. Like, what is 1 second worth? 10 points? 20 points? Surely 1 second must be worth, like, 50 points. Because otherwise it would literally be impossible for me to do that. Like, you can't do that. You can't do this much faster than I'm doing it. Like, I mean, I guess the big thing would be not to fuck up the jumps at the end with the bomb. You know, make it up one clean sequence of jumps. Yeah, see, it is totally impossible to get that down. Because the bomb block has to take a second to actually, like... The bomb blocks have to get down there first. You can't just instantly... The bomb blocks don't just instantly open the moment you hit the bomb block. It has to travel down there. Okay, so that takes about a second to fall down to that door. Sprint, jackass! See, the annoying thing is that, like, the timer starts counting from the moment the screen begins to iris in, before you even realize that you have control. Before your pitiful, feeble human brain is even reacting to the fact that you have control again. You're instantly being, okay, get out of the way. I need to jump there, because I'm messing that up, too. Now, this time, we're not going to sit outside the... There. Get any of that. Throw. I don't know what's faster. Like, what would be faster? Would it be faster to stop there? And, like, resume anew? Walk. See, and you have to wait here. So, like, I literally feel like the only way to save time, the only real way for me to save time, like, so much of this is just waiting. There is so much goddamn waiting. Yeah, I honestly feel like the only real place to save time is right at the end with those jumps while you're holding the bomb. Which is harder than you'd think it would be. Like, it really doesn't seem like it would be that hard, but it totally is. They say that's not bad enough. You can't actually even throw the bomb. Oh, you bastard! I can't believe you just did that. You just bonked me off the... There. 43, almost 44 seconds left. That has to be a platinum. There's no way that isn't a platinum. There's absolutely no way in hell I did not just get a platinum there. Yeah, just barely. I'm fewer points over the threshold than I was behind it before. I mean, well, hang on, like, literally. I was 1,400 points under it before, and now I'm 90 points. Now I'm 90 points over it. Well, thank God we got that done. I totally forgot I was gonna have to do that. We're only up to 24 minutes? How the hell are we only up to 24 minutes here? Well, then again, we only did the first... You know, we only did the first... We only did the first... Or the last, like, fifth of that level. And then we spent, like, probably, like, 16 minutes doing that. Oh, probably, like, 20 minutes, honestly. Alright. Let's go to Dangerous Dinner. Let's fight the Fidol battle. I'm curious if they've added anything here, but mostly I'm just curious to see how it looks. I've not noticed a huge difference in terms of, like, quality of stuff. I actually wanted a souvenir item. I want to take one of my random copy essences, because I like using these when I get to bosses. Because, you know, some of the copy essences are different, because they kind of shoehorn in mecha and sand everywhere they can. But, let's see what we've got. Well, I'm not going to be able to get much use out of that. Good lord. Okay. Sure, great. Festival. You're not gonna give me mecha here. I'll take sand. Normally I'd be using the... I've struggled to make my decision regarding which, like, mask I want to use, because, like, obviously Zero is wonderful, but I'm sad that it doesn't change the voices. Even though Zero doesn't have any voice clips, I think it would be cool if wearing the Zero mask completely muted Kirby's voice. Like, Kirby didn't make any vocalizations at all, you know? And Sectonia would be the obvious choice, but I don't like how they chose only her, like, harsh battle grunts for that. I don't know. Whatever, it's not a big deal. Alright, Landia. Man, your teeth look so gnarly. It has been a while since I have fought vanilla Landia. I fought a whole bunch of Landia in the days of a Team Kirby clash. What I thought you were gonna do. This sand castle move is fucking ridiculous. Man, it's been a while since I fought Landia in general. I didn't play far enough into Super Kirby Clash to run into her. I'm pretty sure she was in that game. There we go. That sandcastle move is so freaking busted. It's kind of unfortunate how little the movesets of the abilities actually matter for fucking anything. Like, because basically every single boss fight in this game just boils down to, every single boss fight in this game basically boils down to, you know, get into the right position, find the right position and timing to spam whatever the strongest attack is that your move has. Like, literally nothing else matters. Every single thing is just DPS, you know? Like, I think, adding the third dimension in Forgotten Land actually made a huge improvement there. Like, having like, the boss fights in Forgotten Land were absolutely fantastic. Please open up. Can I do this with... Yeah, I can. This controller is slightly more cumbersome to shake than a Wii mode. Just slightly. God, if you can name that TV show, you're insane. I think I referenced that all the goddamn time. I want that. You actually move slower with this thing charged. Somehow I never realized that. Yeah, that was close. Oh, you know what I never did? I never looked at Landia's pause screen description. Because all the bosses actually have pause screen descriptions now. I don't think they did in the original. I think it was Triple Deluxe where they really started to do that for every single boss. But, I know, Triple Deluxe, I know Return to Dreamland had a couple, like, Magolor Soul at the very, very end. At the end of the troop, like, the final boss fights all had boss screen descriptions. But I remember, I was looking at some of them, what boss did I first notice it on? I think I first noticed it on Fatty Puffer. dump on, taking a dump on, taking a dump on the can. Taking a dump on, taking a dump on, taking a dump on. I remember when this game was still new, I used to listen to this song while reading El Goodish Shive. Like, I had, like, this association between that webcomic and this song, but only, like, the early years of it for some reason. Like, I wouldn't associate that song. Maybe I would, I don't know. It's a good webcomic. Oh shit, it's the man! Hey dude, you're an asshole. I am really curious to see what they're gonna do in the Magolor Epilogue. What I expect? Because, like, there's stuff. Oh, dang. Was that always what this boss was called? Lore and Magolor? I thought it was just called the Lore Starker. Oh, you know what? Hang on, let's pause. The Lore Starker are now controlled by the three Magolor, who uses it to his friends. If it had a mind of its own, how would it feel at this moment? I don't know. I wonder if they're hinting at something there, like if it's gonna turn out that the Lore Starker actually. Well, because it's implied that Magolor actually stole the Lore Starker. It's another thing like the Master Crown that he stole. Or that he otherwise acquired, you know, because I don't know if anybody necessarily was possessing it whenever he got it. Yeah, I don't know if necessarily anybody was possessing it when he had it. I think he just found it and took it for himself. But, Man, DDD looks so stupid in these new graphics. He looks so stupid! Oh, I'm telling you. It just looks absolutely ridiculous. Whatevs. Let's see what we get here. Fighter, not interested. I would much rather use an ability that I'm not used to than fighter. Still remember when the Runaway guys did this LP, and at the very end of the LP, John wanted to show off how ridiculously overpowered fighter was with its completely invulnerable combo technique, and then he couldn't get it to work because it's not actually that good. Alright. Take a dog, dog. This looks. Looking upscaled. I don't know. I've never played. Well, actually, I have played something before. And I'm actually not playing it anymore right now. Because I didn't have access to. Because I can't record it in 60 FPS. I mean, 1080p with this card. It only supports 60 FPS up to 720. I'm sad I'm not using a Sectonia right now, actually, because I was curious. Although I kind of got my answer, actually, when I played Samurai Kirby. I was curious if she was going to have, you know, cooler voice clips. Man, my mom is working. Oh, you know what? I think you just brought me to my seat. I bet that's what was going on. I bet that's why nobody was calling us, because that was going on. Get back in the foreground where I can attack you, you chode. I don't think I've ever in my life ever gotten hit with those things. Alright. Here we go. You know what I just realized? Those things look just like... What is that thing? That thing on the left, I've never seen that enemy before. What is that? Oh, you know what? Hang on, what does this say? Pulse Soul Halcondra is legendary treasure of the Master Crown. So it could be his. What was I gonna say? Nope, I lost it. The armored health bar. The segments of armor on the health bar, they look like, I never realized until right now that in the fight with Void Termina, when you fight it in its Colossus form, in its Colossus form, its health bar looks the same. It's like armored in the same way, except instead of a star icon, it has like the Void Termina eye. Freaking pain in the butt, you asshole. Oh, bitch. Get out of here. Yeah, he does always do this at this point, doesn't he? Because I have a very clear memory of running away from this thing, well, with the Flare Beam ability. Yep. Part of the song that inexplicably references the Squeak Squad theme for some reason. Go Zero. That was a cool, that was a good angle on Zero's, on the Zero mask there. Alright. Oh, here we go. Now get ready to shake the controller because he's about to block it and it's really cool. Oh shit, he blocked it! Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god! I wonder if that works. Oh yeah, it definitely does. I just totally let go of it. That's a I absolutely love that moment. You think you're about to finish him off, and then suddenly he blade locks you with his wrists. He catches it, and it's like, oh shit. Now if this were a modern, now if this were a new game, this would be where it ends. But this is from like, the turn of the turn of the decade, so. Back when things kept going. Past the point where they could have ended into where it's wonderful. Still just called Magolor. I'm surprised I didn't change this to Magolor Soul. Well, then again, the thing is that this isn't Magolor Soul. Nothing about this is Magolor at this point. That's the messed up thing about it. It's like, at this point, it's not Magolor. It really isn't. I like Beam. Taking a dump. Actually, Beam is a really terrible, probably a really terrible ability for this fight. Anything that flies is harder to hit with Beam's strongest attack, which is obviously the Beam Rain or whatever. Man, he looks so stupid in this form. I mean, like, certain parts, certain aspects of this form look, I think generally speaking, this form of Magolor, open quote, soul, end quote, looks way cooler, like, looks way more, like, it actually looks like the same, oh man, oh my god, I forgot about that attack, oh my god, that's right, Beam hasn't had this attack for, like, 8 games, for 5 games now, I'm taking a beating, I should probably, like, be careful, oh man, this is bad. I'm gonna get rid of those. I'm not really getting much out of, do you need any stars? No. I wasn't really getting much out of that beam. It was not working out. Oh! And here's the part where the dark matter eye becomes visible, and everybody gets to wonder what the fuck the connection there is. Like, gee, there are so many connections between this game and other games. Like, okay, first of all, the Master Crown connects this game to Star Allies because Void Termina uses it in one of its attacks. The Dark Matter Eye poses a connection between the Master Crown and Dark Matter, which that's a whole other can of worms. Oh boy. This is Flare Beam attack. This one's really hard to dodge. But yeah, like, yeah, that suggests, oh my god! That was a lot of scratch damage. Holy shit, did you see that? That did like as much damage as it would have taken if I just taken the hit outright. Uh-oh. Don't leave anything on the ground, fucking asshole. I can't believe you've done this. Ow! I might die. Like, actually. I believe you can skip. I believe you don't have to fight the first man again. If you die here. By the way. Stars there. Shit. I'm used to Magolor Souls patterns, dang it. Oh my god, that's embarrassing. Oh my god, that's embarrassing. Go with Spear. Spear was my favorite ability when I was like, oh, yo, Needle is so good. Yes, absolutely. Yeah, you do skip to this phase. Out of the way. I'm holding down the B button. I really am. No, that. What are you doing? Ow! I'm literally just holding the. Oh, cool. This actually doesn't count as being on front. Like, you can see the spikes beneath the ground. So this isn't like a solid platform or whatever. What other connections are there? There's a connection between this game and Robobot because of the security force in, which is a dead ringer for Metal General. Oh, here we go. Well, he already did this. Hey, is that the same attack? No. That's a dark version of the regular Ultra Sword. There's that one new sword. There's actually a new sword that wasn't. Oh, you know what that sword might be, actually? There's one new sword among the Ultra Swords. It's like a. Okay, you know what I'm gonna do? Instead of standing in the corner, I'm gonna stand right here. Kind of the opposite direction. Thank God you can attack me while I'm doing this. Okay, here we go. This is the most boring possible way to finish him off, but there you go. Did Magolor always skew counterclockwise when he did that? Okay, I'm not watching the whole credit sequence. Please don't make me watch the whole credit sequence. Thank you. Thank you, God. Oh, you know what? I probably should have watched those. I bet there's new stuff at the end. Oh, cool. We get Traitor Magolor. That's the coolest possible. Why have I never heard that form called that? So where does extra mode go? Like, when do you unlock extra mode? Okay, you unlock extra mode now, and then probably the Magolor Epilogue is in the bottom right? Yeah. Okay. And we also get the jukebox. Juke 'em. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna end this right here, and then I'm basically just gonna do an LP. Of the Magolor Epilogue. As stupid as that sounds, but when I haven't even done an LP of the main game yet, I'm just gonna do an LP of the Magolor Epilogue because I need to play through it now. Like, now. So, bye. Bye, like this is an official episode or something.